This next question came in from Sam, and Sam asked, what is a digital file? What is a CD of images? I'm so confused. I hear these terms all the time, and I just don't know what they are. Sam, you're not the only one. I get that question. Unless you work in the photography industry or digital art, digital media industry, most typical everyday people don't necessarily know what that is or what a digital file is. And a lot of times, even people that know how to use a camera don't necessarily understand that lingo unless you actually work in the business. So I'm going to give you a brief little history. So this is film. Let's go back to the olden days, which is when I started shooting. This is a film that I obviously haven't developed yet. Or actually, yes, haven't developed yet. Haven't even used it yet. So this is a roll of film. And when you shoot a roll of film on an old-time camera that we call now, when you take it to the store and you get the film developed, they're going to give you back what's called negatives, okay? Negatives. This is what, from film, you would then have your prints printed from. So when someone developed a roll of film, when they developed this roll of film, they produce negatives. And from the negatives, they then produce your prints. Now, this actually, so this specific negative is actually in a little cover to protect it. But fast forward to the digital age. So any picture you take with your cell phone, with a regular camera, a digital camera, any type of digital camera, if you do a screenshot, anything like that, that's going to create a digital image. So in layman's terms, a negative in digital photography is the digital file. So a negative equals a digital file. So if you have a digital file of an image, one negative file, sorry, one image, whoops, one negative. So this negative actually has 1, 2, 3, 4 images on it, okay? Now, a digital file is one image. So each one of these, and these are numbered, 1, 2, 3, and 4, okay? A digital file would just be image number 1, or image number 2, or image number 3. One digital file, one negative, same thing. Now, when I go out and I photograph a client, every time I click the shutter button, it creates a digital file. That digital file is that one image, one photograph, however you want to say that. So a lot of clients get confused because they think a CD of images is a digital file, and that's not the case. On a CD or on a thumb drive, and here is an example of a thumb drive that I just purchased, okay? One digital image goes on there, and it represents one photograph, one print, one image, however you want to label that. So if somebody sells you a CD of images, that's a CD of digital images, digital files, and you're going to have multiple ones on there. But again, one digital file equals one photograph or one print. That's what it is. Now, how do I work in my business? So you have hobbyists out there who will do a little shoot and they'll give you the digital files here. Most professional photographers, if not all of them, value their digital files because they are your negatives. So just like you wouldn't go to a restaurant and the restaurant wouldn't give you the recipe with everything you order, I'm not going to give you digital files of everything you order from me. Now, photographers work out different packages because everyday society, they want those digital files for social media or just to keep on their phone. So that is when you get into high resolution versus low resolution. High resolution files, digital files, are formatted to print. That means the files are really large and they will give you great detail when you print them. Now, a low resolution file will print out pixelated. It won't look very good, if at all possible. And a low resolution file is specifically for the internet, for social media, for emailing, for websites. That's what a low resolution file is. So the next time someone says, I have a digital file, They mean that one digital file represents one image, one photograph, one print. So if I create an image in color and I take that image and I create it in black and white, I've then created two digital files, one color, one black and white, and each represents a separate photograph. So I hope that explains that.